Hello and welcome to another edition of Joining the Rush on allhockey.ru. My name is Steve Dangle and this is
Andreas Sashenka.
And I'm doing steroids.
It's not steroids, it's gum.
I don't know what steroids look like, but I'm Russian, therefore I do steroids. You know that, right?
Oh, do we have a treat for you? Andre, you know how we say Vetus is just a gold mine for hockey comedy?
Yeah.
We found the mother load. Okay, so here's what happened. An article was written recently by a Pittsburgh sportscaster that didn't directly accuse Ovechkin of doing steroids, but basically implied he did steroids. And a gentleman by the name of Ryan Lambert, you can follow him on Twitter at @2linepass, decided to research this article. And he discovered that the article written about Ovechkin was, how do you say crap in Russian?
Dis-moi.
And he writes an article basically going, hey, you're stupid. Radio show host didn't like that, and he had Lambert on his show. That was a mistake. We'll only summarize bits and pieces of it because we don't want this video to be half an hour long, but we're gonna post a link in the underbar to Yahoo Sports. It's the entire interview, 28 minutes long. I cried laughing. Essentially, the host was like, well, I assume Ovechkin did steroids because of this, this, and this. And one of his points was, and don't get mad at me, I didn't say it, he did. One of his points was many female Russian Olympians during the 70s did steroids. Ovechkin's mom, I don't know if you know this, was a Russian Olympian in the 70s. Also, she's a female. Therefore, might have done steroids, am I right? So if she did steroids, then her son must have done steroids, right?
Well, it's a well-known fact that humans do more steroids than kangaroo. Therefore, since Ovechkin's mom is a human, she's more likely to do steroids than kangaroo.
Oh my god. My personal favorite part of the interview is when Lambert said this. Well, Sidney Crosby's a vampire. And because you think it's okay to accuse Ovechkin of being guilty until proven innocent, then Sidney Crosby is a vampire until you can prove that he's not. That's not what they said word for word, but that's what the conversation broke down to. So all I have to say to two-line pass Ryan Lambert, well done. Bravo. Like I said, it's 28 minutes long, so our friend Andre here, since I don't know Russian, is gonna translate the whole thing.
And you better read it.
It's a great way to spend a Thursday. So, my steroid-doing kangaroo vampire friend, what would you like to talk about next?
The editor realignment, sir.
Nice Canucks shirt. How's Luongo doing?
It's Kessler, dude.
Okay, fine.
Just got a little torn out during the riots.
So this week, the NHL was all like, let's confuse the hell out of the casual fans! The hardcore fans get it, and we have our skepticisms. What the NHL has now is two conferences, three divisions per conference for a total of six. Each division has five teams in it. Was that too many numbers?
Math and steroids just don't work. Was that a dying elephant you were trying to impersonate?
Yes. On steroids.
Elephant steroids.
For people who are extreme! But anyway, what's gonna happen now is there will be four conferences, no more divisions, two of the conferences are gonna have eight teams, and two of the conferences are gonna have seven.
Okay, how is that easier?
It's not. Okay, it's helpful to some teams, helpful to others. Let me explain. The one very good thing to come out of it is every single team in the NHL plays every single team.
See, in Russia we have a saying, без политры не разберешься. That means you have to put a half a liter of alcohol in your body in order to solve the problem. Might as well do that.
Well, Andre, the way you make the playoffs, basically, is you have to finish a certain place in your conference. So basically, that much hasn't changed. You still need to finish a certain place in your conference. And in the first round of the playoffs, whoever makes it from each conference has to play each other. So you're playing a team from your conference in the first round. And then by the time you get to the third round, there's only four teams left. And what happens is they just reseed the teams, and then you play each other based on those seeds. So then, theoretically speaking, you could have...
Wait. I gotta go pee.
Oh. Are you good?
What?
Okay. So theoretically speaking, because they have to reseed the final four teams, you could see a Stanley Cup final featuring two Eastern Conference teams or two Western Conference teams. Well, I say Eastern and Western Conference, but I mean, they're gonna rename them as well.
So, is there anything like rest of it?
Well, yeah, Tampa and Florida are basically in what is currently the Northeast Division. Which, if you're talking about the KHL, is kind of like saying, hey, let's put Boris Astana in a division with St. Petersburg.
Thank you very much for watching. That's been all for
No, we're not done.
Andre.
Need you to sober up, bud.
Okay.
Last but not least, someone got suspended for hitting Ryan Miller, and it wasn't Milan Lucic.
But he was wearing yellow.
You want to take this one? Because you haven't really said much.
Yeah, but I got drunk. So Nashville Predators enforcer Jordan Tootoo crashed into Ryan Miller, and his buddies didn't like it all too much.
No.
And the resulting suspension is 2 games. I'm no Brendan Shanahan, but I think I know why he got only 2 games.
Why?
Well, how should I put it? He served a little bit of his sentence during that game.
Well, Andre, I can't read Russian, so let's take some questions, can you tell me?
Today we picked a few interesting questions, and they both involve hair. So here we go, question number one. Who in all of hockey has the best mustache?
Currently, I'm gonna go with Ottawa Senators head coach Paul MacLean.
As you can see, he's had this mustache for a while.
The best of all time, though? Lanny McDonald. 1989 Stanley Cup champions with the Calgary Flames.
Should have been with the Leafs.
You put that back on.
I got cold.
Speaking of the guys who have to cover the head, bald guys. So who is the best bald guy in hockey?
I'm gonna go with another head coach. He just registered his first win with the Anaheim Ducks, Bruce Boudreau. And if he had just borrowed some of those steroids from Ovechkin's mom, he could have grown some hair.
He also may be a kangaroo.
Totally, and a vampire.
Hockey is rather unpredictable.
I think we're on to something. Those should be the names of the conferences. So we'll have the Vampire Conference, the Steroids Conference,
Kangaroo Conference.
Kangaroo Conference. We need a fourth one. The Chittipashka Conference. Vampire, steroids, kangaroos, little turtle.
Tonight's matchup brought to you by Joining the Rush. The Columbus Blue Jackets of the Vampire Conference meet for the very first time in the season, the Buffalo Sabres of the Steroids Conference.
Last but not least, my friends and comrades, the goal of the week.
Появилось первое звено, и вот как здорово все завершает свой же проход Иван Хлынцев.
That was sick.
How do you say wow in Russian?
Wow.
Wow.
Well, that really does it for this episode of Joining the Russian All Hockey RU. My name is Andreas Sashenko. This guy is
Steve Dangle. And don't forget to check the underbar, because this guy right here is going to translate that whole crazy radio interview with Ovechkin, Ovechkin's mom, and Sidney Crosby being a vampire.
Ooh, sorry.
I'm okay.
Open your mouth. don't work together.
Finish a certain place in your conference. Oh, was there beer in it?
Yeah. Just a little bit.
Now I got the hiccups.
Is it on?
Yep. Okay, not quite like that. And then just like fly down or something. Yeah, here, actually start. Well, I knew that would happen.